This week on Cracked Science, it is possible to fight back against institutionalized pseudoscience, and I will show you this one trick that's worked again and again. Hey, this is Jonathan Jerry, and you're watching Cracked Science, the show from the McGill Office for Science and Society that separates sense from nonsense on the scientific stage. Speaking of nonsense, people often ask me what they can do to counter the tidal wave of misinformation they encounter in the news. I mean, we've got chiropractors selling quantum clips to make you stronger, doctors writing about the evils of vaccination in all caps, a movie actress telling you to stick whatever expensive crap she finds around her house up your hoo-ha. It's so much BS, I often have to leave my office and come back with my special air freshener. Now, there is something you and I can do, something that has been shown to work. And no, I do not mean forsaking civilization and shacking up with your teddy bear. Let's look at Georgian College. Georgian College is a public post-secondary education college in Ontario, where you can learn about aviation management, as well as welding techniques, and anything in between. And very recently, Georgian College was interested in creating a new program. You might have heard of it. Some people say it was a bit watered down compared to its usual offerings, though it was still a hard pill to swallow. It was homeopathy. Georgian College wanted to start a homeopathy program. Now, I joke about it because it helps me maintain my sanity, but for a Canadian public college to offer a homeopathy degree in 2018, it's about as absurd as the upcoming Sharknado sequel, Sharknado 30C, Hanuman's Revenge. Tagline, "Where are the sharks?" For those of you who don't know what homeopathy is and thus find themselves unable to fully enjoy this priceless gag, let me give you a primer on homeopathy. It's a 222-year-old healing philosophy created by German doctor Samuel Hahnemann. While many people confuse it with herbal medicine, homeopathy is actually based on three very absurd foundational beliefs. First, the principle of like cures like. Because poison ivy causes a rash in healthy people, it will treat a rash regardless of its cause. This is a principle stolen from the book of sympathetic magic. For example, this candle is supposed to cure impotence because it's shaped like a Viagra pill. Now, a homeopath wouldn't rub poison ivy directly on your rash, and this brings us to its second principle, dilutions. The more you dilute something, the more powerful it becomes. Homeopathic remedies are diluted to such an extent they often only contain a few molecules, and sometimes none at all. Oscillococcinum, which is sold as a flu remedy in so many pharmacies, famously contains not a single bit of the original duck's heart and liver because of its absurd dilution factor. In order to explain how nothing can still work, homeopaths have more recently affirmed the following third belief, that the water in which the dilutions are made has memory, so it remembers the original ingredient. As songwriter Tim Minchin is famous for singing,
"Water has memory, and whilst its memory of a long-lost drop of onion juice seems infinite, it somehow forgets all the poo it's had in it."
Homeopathy, with its Latin phrases, leather-bound books, and antiquated words like proving and miasms, is the closest thing to full-on Harry Potter cosplay you'll ever have a chance to pay for. Which is why it made perfect sense for a Canadian college to decide to squeeze this in between programs in hairstyling and hospitality. Sarcasm aside, something really interesting happened. Georgian College announced it was canceling this program before it even began. And the why is both obvious and instructive. Public shaming has a sordid history, whether with pillories, scarlet letters, and that thing Bart Simpson has been doing for the past 29 years. Seriously, what's Bart's anti-aging secret? But public shaming does seem to work when it comes to institutions who promote pseudoscience. And how this public humiliation of Georgian College's homeopathy program started was, well, because of one of you. A woman reached out to me, Chris Labos, Joe Schwartz, and Tim Caulfield and told us what Georgian College was planning to do. Tim, the proud recipient of a Twitter brain chip and thus always connected to the Twitter sphere, tweeted about this to his 29,000 followers. More people jumped on the bandwagon. The mainstream media picked up on it, ran the story, and Georgian College canceled the program. All of this in less than a month. Now, I have no delusions that such public pushback will dilute homeopathy out of existence. This is not about winning the war, but coming to appreciate the small victories we can have when promoting intellectual rigor and good science. Here's another small victory involving sugar pills. CBC Marketplace ran a shocking exposé of Health Canada's laissez-faire when it came to the marketing of homeopathic products aimed at children with a fever. They did it by creating their own bogus product called Nidon, a clever anagram of nothing, as it was designed to be a homeopathic solution. As proof that their product would work to relieve fever and pain, they sent in photocopies of an old homeopathic book. And what was Health Canada's response?
And 5 months later, out on a shoot, we get word.
Oh, the moment of truth. Did we get our product license? Let's see. Yep, we did. Nidon is approved for the relief of fever, pain, and inflammation. We even got a product number. Unbelievable.
Now, Health Canada ended up with egg on its face because Marketplace is a national TV show, and a lot of Canadians realized the night it aired that they were being bamboozled. So Health Canada made changes. They started to require scientific evidence for children's homeopathic cold and flu products. What about homeopathy for teething products? What about adult homeopathic products? No changes. Changing institutional policies is a little bit like one person trying to move the institutional building itself. But you don't need the budget of a national TV show to publicly shame institutions. Twitter will do. When Dr. Daniel Needis published an anti-vaccination screed on a local Cleveland website, it was Twitter that brought him to the attention of the media. Over the course of a single weekend, Dr. Needis' infantile ramblings generated a tsunami of angry tweets by medical doctors, science communicators, and concerned citizens. And many of these tweets tagged the Cleveland Clinic's official account. Soon, the mainstream media was exposing the story, and the clinic had to act. Dr. Needis went from being the director of the Cleveland Clinic Wellness Institute to leaving the medical center and co-founding a private wellness clinic with a fellow anti-vaxxer. But fear not, the Cleveland Clinic is still the epicenter of quackademic medicine. But we did win a small victory there. Georgian College will not be offering a full program in homeopathy, and we should rejoice. But it's not like all of its programs are in line with the scientific consensus. It still offers an advanced diploma in acupuncture, a certification in reflexology, and a full-time program in traditional Chinese medicine. And look, you will get hands-on experience in state-of-the-art labs. Because nothing says tradition like state-of-the-art equipment. Maybe they're using acupuncture needles made with space-age material. Who knows? Who knows? But these little victories, and they are little victories, remind me of a very old saying, sunlight is the best disinfectant. Speaking of the power of sunlight, this also reminds me of Buffy the Vampire Slayer. In its last season, she and her friends decided to break tradition and spread the power of the Slayer to every potential candidate. And this is how we can fight the forces of tradition, intuition, and anti-science. So join Twitter, and when you see something, say something. Because as Buffy reminds us, sunlight is indeed the best disinfectant. My recommendation this week is the CBC Marketplace episode entitled License to Deceive. Host Erica Johnson decides to show how easy it is to get a homeopathic product officially licensed by Health Canada. For those of you who think that a Health Canada number on a product ensures safety and efficacy, think again. You can view the episode on YouTube or on the Marketplace website. This video series is one small part of what our office does, so go to mcgill.ca/OSS and see what else we do to help separate sense from nonsense, and do subscribe to our newsletter. You can follow me on Twitter @crackedscience, and join us next time for science that may or may not be all it's cracked up to be.